मुझे तो लगता है हमारा सीजन रामायण था
कंपेयर टू दिस दैट इज ट्रू.
आई फील के आसिम को थोड़ा पूरे सीजन में इट्स ऑलवेज बिन लाइक यू शट अप, यू आर रॉन्ग, यू हैव डन दिस.
ट्रू.
एंड या द पुअर गाय आर्ग्यूज अ बिट, सो दैट्स ऑल्सो गोइंग अगेंस्ट हिम. वो चुप बैठ के यार सॉरी बोल देना क्या फर्क पड़ता है, दूसरा बंदा भी वही कर रहा है.
द वे इट केम आउट because you guys were not fighting too much, it seemed or the makers made it seem like maybe they are going to patch up.
Yes.
Aisa tha, I agree.
Yes. So, and to be honest, I wanted to keep that decorum.
Yeah.
I wanted ke yaar jo bhi ho, he is my ex-husband today, but we've had a past, we've shared things together. I didn't want that to be out in the open. Like today, I really feel bad for Rashmi.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of hard work, a lot of a lot of struggle that an actor goes through, makes a name, comes at the top, then enters Bigg Boss, only to know that tumhari life ke sare chapters out in the open ho rahe.
Bigg Boss 13 might be considered as one of the most violent and volatile seasons of all time, but today I have somebody who's possibly the calmest contestant ever on the show, Delnaaz Irani, and one of my favorites actually. Welcome, Delnaaz.
Thank you, Nandi. Thank you so much.
How have you been?
I've been very good. Perfect. See, I'm so happy to be on your show.
Yes, finally. You know, we've been discussing it for quite some time. And like I have said, that I have loved you on Bigg Boss in that season. You know, the grace, the dignity that you had. Do you see that missing in this season's Bigg Boss? Or maybe over the time, that has gone down, you know? The kind of dignity... झगड़े भी डिग्निफाइड होते थे तब के तब. अभी बहुत
मुझे तो लगता है हमारा सीजन रामायण था
कंपेयर टू दिस दैट इज ट्रू.
हमारा सीजन इतना ठंडा लगता है आज की तारीख में कि मुझे लगता है कि मैं खुद जाके मतलब यू नो रिवाइंड करके बोलो अरे कुछ करो तुम लोग कुछ करो. बट यू नो द सैड बिट इज दैट ओनली जब मेकर्स या इनडायरेक्टली मेकर्स बोलते हैं कि भाई कुछ करो कुछ करो, पीपल टेक इट यू नो कुछ करो बोलते हैं द नेक्स्ट डे देयर आर फाइट्स. सो दैट इज समथिंग व्हिच इज नॉट गुड. यू नो व्हाट प्रोबब्ली एवरी थिंग दैट इज सपोज टू बी देयर इन द शो इज नॉट सपोज टू एंड इन अ फाइट और इन अ स्पैट और इन गाली गलोच और इन यू नो धक्का मुक्की. Which is, this is the first season where the rules have been broken.
Broken like so many times. But what is happening today is violent. You know, like you said, the rules are being broken. Everybody's pushing everybody. And it's not just Siddharth. Because Siddharth has also pushed people. But so has Himanshi. And there's been fights, physical fights between Shefali, Shehnaz, Rashmi. Everything has happened. Do you think that Bigg Boss somehow let it loose this time?
Yeah, I feel. That's what I'm saying. कि करो जितना करना है करो एंटरटेन. सो ऐसा ही विथ मी माय पर्सनल फेवरेट दिस सीजन इज शहनाज. सो आई फील आई कनेक्ट विथ हर. लाइक इफ शी क्राइज आई आल्सो क्राई एंड
पर्सनली
प्लीज डोंट क्राई यार बकवास मत कर डोंट क्राई
रियली.
या सो येस्टरडेज एपिसोड व्हेन ही सलमान जस्ट सेड दैट यू नो मायरा इज सेफ एंड हार्दिक एंड टप 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 मेरे आंसू गिर रहे. मैंने बोला क्या हो रहा है भाई.
You are so connected to her then.
I like the girl.
But she's entertaining. To be honest, like Shehnaz is very funny, very entertaining. Let's get this straight. Because in your season, was the first season where a person came up with an ex-partner, you know.
Yes.
You came in with Rajiv after you guys had a divorce.
Yes.
And everybody expected firecrackers and fights and matlab ekdam gandapan hoga, but hua nahi tha, which you guys maintained. Like you guys of course did have arguments, but it didn't land up in a fight or a ruckus. Rashmi and Siddharth are inside, and of course everybody knows that they have shared a past, and it has been brought up too many times, and you know it is possibly also the reason why their relationship is very volatile. How do you see the reaction between them? Because you know it's almost similar.
Yeah.
But the way you guys reacted compared to how they are reacting to each other.
I don't think it's similar. We are 14 years of marriage.
Yeah. Not similar, but they try, tried to do a similar year.
Yes. But every relationship, I guess, Nandeep, is different. Everybody is different. Every person. Like when I saw Rajiv in the house for the first time, I was like, okay, matlab, those 20 seconds, I was like, oh my God, what's going to happen? But then, I guess, as the days went by, I just, see, we were already divorced. It was all done, yeah, over with. But obviously, people were there, they were asking, those who knew about it, they were constantly asking, those who knew a little bit, they were trying to patch us up, ke kya hua, kya hua, which wasn't really needed. You know, because I made it very clear that yaar, ho chuka hai, we are done, yeah, over with. And even the makers probably somewhere tried, wanted, tried. And
ki jhagda nahi ho raha to patch up to ho hi jaye. Because you guys were actually, the way it came out, because you guys were not fighting too much, it seemed, or the makers made it seem like maybe they are going to patch up. Yes. Aisa tha, I agree. Yes.
So, and to be honest, I wanted to keep that decorum. Yeah. I wanted, ke, yaar, jo bhi ho, he is my ex-husband today, but we've had a past, we've shared things together. I didn't want that to be out in the open. Like today, I really feel bad for Rashmi.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of hard work, a lot of, what do I say, a lot of struggle that an actor goes through, makes a name, comes at the top, then enters Bigg Boss, only to know that tumhari life ke sare chapters out in the open ho rahe, you know. So that is a little bit which is very hurtful. For us, it was actually easier because I guess I was, yeah, very clear in my head, though Raji was a little bit forceful at times. But I will give it to him that, you know, he was also very, he was not crossing that
line
at all. And I got a lot of support from him also in the game as a contestant, yeah, with me. So there was a lot of support also. Maybe that's why people felt that they will patch up. Haan. But aisa kuch bhi nahi hone wala tha, you know.
But you know, like you said, you've known Rashmi for so many years. Yes. And she's done enough work as, yeah, and she's really a credible actress,
yes,
and a performer.
Yes.
Today when her personal life has been like bared all out, you know, everything is all out there, right?
Yes.
And the whole breakup has happened on a, yes, on national television. Initially when she came in, there were reports that she might get married, and from that to coming to a point where she's saying that I am done with this relationship, and that too on national television. I feel that Rashmi tried to hide it for some time, like I will not do it on national television. Uske bhai ne bhi aake bola ki meri behan nahi chahti thi ye bolne ko ki national television pe bolna hai. But she was put through that situation, yeah, where everybody, I think, being a friend, if you also would have gone inside, you would have told her that, listen, what is happening? What are you doing? How do you take that? Like this whole incident and that whole episode.
Very sorry and very, I feel there's a lot of similarity between my very, very dear friend who I consider like my younger sister, Ashka Goradia, was, yeah, with me in the season.
Yeah.
I find a lot of similarity between these two girls. They're both Gujaratis. I have this connect with them. And you won't believe it, they're very, very respectful, like say, even age-wise and even, you know, in the industry, I'm senior to both these girls. So, I'll just give you a small example that when you meet an elderly person, they always say, tame kem cho, you know. So, they've always said tame, they've never said tu also.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of respect, that kind of, these girls have that kind of upbringing. I see a lot of warmth in that person.
True.
A lot of love, a lot of respect, a lot of warmth for people. Every time that I've met Rashmi, she's been very sweet, respectful. I feel very bad for her watching something like this. That it's her life, yaar. Maybe she wanted to take a decision.
Out of.
And come on, she's a matured person. She's dealing with 20,000
so
people, you know, on a daily basis. She's done daily soap, she's done so much work, she's done events, she's been there. That's why, yeah, she's in the house today. And aaj popularity wise dekho to Siddharth and Rashmi are the
most
popular people today in the, yeah, house. Even anybody, I'm saying, even for that matter Siddharth, or for that matter Rashmi or Aarti or whoever, they are all people who have really worked hard and they've reached a position and now they've come into the house. So I guess, you know, doing something like this, or maybe, you know, getting their past, or zabardasti wo pata nahi wo Arhaan aaya bhi kyun ghar pe. Even if she has realized that this is a big faux pas in life, or this is like something terrible in life that has happened, I still feel that she was graceful enough to just cover up everything.
True. But do you think that the show has been biased in any way? A lot of people, there's been a trend which says BB biased BB 13.
Even I feel. Even I feel a little bit, because I feel that, you know, see, everybody has their favorites. I would like to say that the maker should be very fair, because you calling everybody on the same platform. True. Treat them equal, even if they are one up or one down. Treat everybody equal. You are their parents. It's like you have these True. 14 children,
kids,
and you have to take care of them. And life mein bhi aise hi hota hai ki jab maa baap ek bacche ko zyada bhav dete aur dusre ko nahi na, there's sibling rivalry. Ye hota hai ghar mein.
What are the two instances that you feel that as a viewer, you know, you like you said that you when you watch it, you don't watch it as a contestant and as an audience. What are the two things or instances where you felt that they could have been a little fair?
Most of the times I felt with Asim. Most of the times. Not that I am an Asim fan, or not that I am a ardent supporter. Like, I've seen people going mad on Twitter.
Yeah. You mean unfair with Asim?
Yeah. So, I've actually seen people, it's like Asim ka followers and Siddharth ka followers, aise lagta hai, wo log talwar leke nikle hai, pure din mein kuch kaam nahi karte. True. Sirf Twitter pe hai, and sirf they are supporting these two. And I feel it's madness.
Yeah.
You know, so I am saying I'm not an Asim fan or a huge Siddharth fan. But being fair to both, I feel that it is a little unfair. I feel that Asim ko thoda pure season mein, it's always been like, you shut up, you are wrong, you have done this.
True.
The poor guy argues a bit. So that's also going against him. वो चुप बैठ के यार सॉरी बोल देना क्या फर्क पड़ता है, दूसरा बंदा भी वही कर रहा है, तो इट्स ओके.
Who will be your top three contestants according to you or as an audience? Who do you think will reach top three?
Okay, so according to जनता and according to what the game is like, then I see Siddharth Asim for sure, and maybe Rashmi or Shehnaz in the third position. Like overall, but if you ask me, personally, my personal choice, then it has to be the three girls, Aarti, Rashmi and Shehnaz.
Okay.
Or I would say Shehnaz, Rashmi and Aarti.
In that order.
I like Shehnaz because she's entertained me completely for 140 True. Days. Of course, I started watching the game thoda der se, but she's complete entertainer, and I really wish that girl should come here and work in the industry, because she's got all the talent.
True.
And she's pretty, she's all there, and I think she'll do well. So, I mean, she's really a sweetheart.
Yeah.
So I wish all well for her, you know, and I really, really like her. Really like her. She's a sweetheart.
Thank you for this conversation. It was lovely to have you and your insights on Bigg Boss. And I hope to see you soon.
Thank you, Nandi. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi guys, I'm Delnaaz Irani, and if you've liked this video, please like, subscribe and share to Pinkwilla.